Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Briareus Kerensky, and welcome to the final video of the 2021 version of Games I've Bought But I've Never Played. And as usual, this video is not about a game I've bought but never played, but an unboxing video featuring various smaller games I never got the chance to show you on this channel. And what better way to close this year than with a bunch of Serran Kagura games? I have the original Japanese release of the very first game, because I've already unboxed Burst, the European version of Burst, Pitchball and Serran Kagura Reflections, the Japanese version, Serran Kagura Reflections and Pitchball in their US incarnation. So let's get started with the very first Serran Kagura. This is Serran Kagura Shoujo Tachi no Shinei, the very first title in the Serran Kagura franchise. And this is of course the Japanese edition, because this game only exists in that country. On the front cover there are the 10 girls, Hanzo on the left and Ebijo on the right. This is the title, and of course 0D due to nice things. And on the back, three descriptive screenshots, a list of technical details, and above everything else we have the key art for all of the main girls. Let's take a look inside. That it's kind of sparse, as you would expect from a 3DS box. Here is the cartridge. And here we have Club Nintendo membership. And no advertisement, but we do have an instruction manual. And it's quite a hefty one, starting off with an introduction to all of the playable and unplayable characters, an illustration, and of course the controls. Oh, also combo list, nice, with indication on the levels the buttons are unlocked. Credits, and the manual is complete. Let's go on to the extra material that came with this game. The first Serran Kagura came with just one bonus, as you see here, this small art book. Although I should say that maybe it's three bonuses, because this art book also includes a drama CD and a soundtrack. And before getting into it, I also have these pre-order bonus. I think it's a bit too old for me to remember clearly. This is a telephone card, a thing that you don't really see anymore, from AmiAmi, as you can see down here from that retailer's bonus. I think this was one of my first, if not the first, order I ever did to AmiAmi. But enough of that, and let's get into this art book that on the front cover has Yomi. And if I'm not mistaken, this is all about the characters. Because being the first game in the series and featuring girls, you wanted to introduce the characters to the players. And aside that, there isn't much in this art book, but it's understandable because this was a gamble of Marvel on Marvelous part. And if you want to know more about the genesis of Serran Kagura, I have a full retrospective about the whole franchise, and yes, I am still plugging those videos. And this is the bigger version of the telephone card. And a nice group shot of the Hanzo girls to conclude the illustration part of this art book that has, well, not quite a young coma to close everything. And here are the two discs. Drama CD in purple, soundtrack in red. And both have Asuka on the cover. From Japan to Europe for the first physical release of a Serran Kagura game outside Japan, Serran Kagura Burst. America will only get a digital release on the 3DS eShop, unfortunately for them, although I must say I have that and I couldn't resist when Marvelous announced a physical release for Europe. On the back, just two screenshots, a very nice shot of Katsuragi, and also the slogan is kind of fun. This was when people and video games could have fun with their content. So, in here we see the cartridge. And on the other side we have a bunch of stuff that I don't even remember what it is. So a manual of course and Club Nintendo. I've never redeemed this pin. I don't really know why. But oh well. And this is the manual which is not like the manual in the Japanese edition, but rather a folded leaflet, which is similar to what Marvelous will do with later releases of this game. And in fact, what a lot of publishers will do for 3DS games. Not as in-depth as the Japanese release of the first game, but at least it's something. The European edition of Serran Kagura came with two bonuses, or at least I think. The first, and I'm sure this is related to Serran Kagura Burst European edition, is this lenticular poster. And as you can see, the 3D effect is not that deep, and it's just about the various planes the girls and the backgrounds are on. The second bonus that I think comes from the European edition of Serran Kagura Burst is this bright red t-shirt featuring Asuka. And I say I think because I've actually forgot about this t-shirt while doing the retrospective, so I'm showing it off now. Judging by the logo, yes, it is from the European edition of Burst, but I cannot be sure, although I'm showing this right now, or I have no other place where to show this off. From a set of first releases to a set of very late releases for Serra & Kagura, starting with the Japanese deluxe pack of Peach Ball, that not only includes Peach Ball, but also, if we go to the back, you can see that it also includes the premium version of Refle, which is a single cartridge with all the five girls and most of the DLC. Back to the front to take another look at the five girls featured in Peach Ball, which incidentally are also the five girls in Refle. And let's just take a quick look around the box, but it's just a red frame. And on the back, Peach Ball with three screenshots and Refle with four. And here you have the contents of this box, edition. Technical details, not much to say, and opening this. Peach Ball and Refle. Yes, they fit in the frame, great. Let's start with Peach Ball, so I can stop saying Peach Ball. Front cover, the same girls we've seen before. And on the back, again, the five girls with... are they the three same screenshots? Yes, they are, because why take new screenshots to promote your game? Inside, Switch cartridge, a small manual typical of Switch releases, and a motif for the inner cover. Starting off with the girls, a brief description of the game and the story, controls. And nothing more. Let's go on to Refle Premium. Same five girls, and on the back, just in a vertical layout, Asuka and the other four with what's inside this box, of course. The classroom as a background for the inside of this box. Switch cartridge with a stark black background and premium in gold. And of course the manual for this game. Which isn't really much, in fact. Because, well, the game isn't much. Once again, let's get outside Japan, this time for the American release of Peach Ball and Reflexions. I think Reflexions has been manufactured or published or just sold by Limited Run Games. It's not one of their numbered releases, but their printing run was quite small, and this goes for quite a hefty price. Now, Peach Ball, the game that we'll start with, not so much, or at least to my knowledge right now. Just two screenshots, which at least are different from the Japanese release, a different illustration for all the characters, and another nice humorous slogan. inside we have the illustration we've seen on the Japanese box switch cartridge. And as a bonus, we have a manual and this which is a simple set of stickers. Nice illustration, and we are done with the manual for Peach Ball. Serran Kagura Reflections, which is not called premium, at least not on the cover, with a rather nice illustration of Yomi. On the back, pretty much what we've seen on the Japanese edition of this game. And I see there is a reverse cover which mimics the Japanese edition, and I doubt I moved it over when I bought it because this doesn't seem damaged along the borders. But oh well, at least there is a reverse cover. And the manual seems pretty much the same as the Japanese edition, only in a different language, of course. I think some of the screenshots are also different. And with this, I conclude the 2021 edition of Games I've Bought But I've Never Played for one reason or another. I hope you have enjoyed this, and also you have enjoyed these, let's say, lesser Serran Kagura editions I was never able to quite fit into the whole unboxing stuff I do. I don't know if this will be the last video of the year, but if it is, I hope you will have relaxing vacations and a wonderful holiday season. I hope you have enjoyed this video, the videos I've done during this year, and you will stick around for more and for all of 2022. Briarios Kerensky, over and out.